Yeah, I'm just waiting on some paperwork to be brought out to me about allegations that I have from the other night, from them violating the Bain Act, and Sergeant Richards, and Sergeant, or Officer Plump, badge number 65 is his badge number. I don't know.
Do you have a pen?
No, I don't.
All right, here's a pen too for you. Pull all that out when you're done, stick it right back in here, okay?
Okay, I can put in an anonymous records request, right? Every police department does it.
No, we gotta have somebody give it to you. You gotta pay for the pages. It's 25 cents a page.
Okay.
It says right on there at the top in the black.
Usually, they'll like call or say that they're ready and I can come down and pay for it, and they just send it to my email account.
Send it to you in email?
Yeah, get the email first about it being complete, that I need to come down and pay. And then I come down and pay, and you guys send it directly to the email.
Oh, I don't know. The girl that does it's right here. She doesn't, I don't think we've ever sent them an email. I'm not saying we can't, I guess, but.
Well, I've always done it that way before, in Oklahoma and New Mexico.
Yeah, we must be old.
Texas, California.
Huh. Yeah, we always just print them, and they sit up here in a stack, and you come pick them up.
Oh, wow.
I don't know, add your email on there too, and maybe that's something you can work out when it's all ready. I don't know.
Okay.
Sound good?
Okay.
Yep.
All right, thanks.
No problem.
We got a police department records request. And here we go, filling it out. Since I'm putting my name as my email, do I put my date of birth on there?
Yep. All that information at the top needs to be filled out.
What about the phone number?
Yeah, if that's how you want to be contacted so that we know to come down.
Well, I wanted to be contacted through the email.
Okay.
Okay.
We'll do correspondence through email.
Do you guys have the incident number for that night?
What's that?
The incident report for that night.
Okay, you're looking for a copy of that? What exactly are you looking for?
Well, a copy of it would be nice, but for that, I need the incident number.
Oh, you know, you don't have to worry about that right now. I'm not exactly sure how to look it up. It's going to take you a while if I don't have any names listed. Just put the date on there. As to what when it happened, if you know approximate time that it happened,
okay,
we'll look it up. The only reason they want specific numbers, is because sometimes we'll have an ongoing issue in a day with somebody, and we'll have to do it, respond 3-4 times, and we'll have 3 or 4 different complaints.
The only two officers that I know are LaPlante and Richards.
LaPlante and Richards, okay, yeah, if you want to listen to those, that'll help you find it too.
I mean, yeah, that would probably help find the incident, because it was, the 7th and 8th, it happened after 11 p.m. on the 7th and before 4 o'clock on the 8th.
Gotcha. Okay. Well, the initial complaint would have been started on the 7th, so go ahead and just put it like the 7th, okay?
Okay.
Yeah, I don't know what the incident number is. I have to have an individual who was involved in the complaint in order to, not just one of the officers, but somebody that we were actually responding to.
Am I able to get how many officers are actually under investigation right now?
That I do not know. That would be something that you.
I just need a number.
I don't know how many officers are under investigation.
Okay.
I really don't know. That's something that would go to the chief. I'm just a dispatcher.
I hear you.
I'm a citizen.
Yeah, you and I both.
I'm a civil servant, so. No, I'm not privy to that information, unfortunately. That would be something you would need to speak to the chief about. Unfortunately, he's not here today. He had matters to tend to.
Well, I understand that.
Yeah, absolutely.
You're part of We the People.
Absolutely. Well, I'm definitely part of We the People.
Like this.
Yeah, I saw that when you came in. That's pretty cool.
I'm all decked out in my red, white, and blue.
Okay. Only way to be here, right?
Oh, yeah.
You gotta support your colors.
Well, I'm a proud veteran, too, so. Yeah, Desert Shield and Storm.
Oh, wow.
Look at this. Oh, shit.
Oh, that is so cool. That is really cool.
The Apache helicopter, wow. Stealth fighter. I had to put the parachute guys on there, even though they went up there by bus. They didn't get dropped in.
Oh, well, that's no fun.
Yeah. I went farther than they did, and I was just a guy in a unit of 8 people. You know, I went all the way up to Abu Dhabi.
Oh, cool.
That sucked. Yeah. Went through the oil fires and everything. How do you spell that officer's name, Plant? Are you still there? How do you spell Officer Plant's name?
Brock,
say that again.
Hold on just a second before we get on the
phone. Okay. It's all right, I can't see you anyway,
I know, I apologize, it's a whole security issue thing. You looking for Dispatcher Brock spelling?
No, Officer Plant?
Oh, Plant, P-L-A-N-T-E.
P-L-A-N-T-E.
Plant with an E at the end, yep.
Okay. What's the date today?
Today's the 11th.
When you do the upstate audits part, it's all one thing. It's not no gap in between upstate and audit. Can I talk to another officer real quick?
Okay, I'm sorry, what was your question?
Can I talk to that other officer real quick?
Officer Pernice?
Yeah.
Let me see if I can find it.
Okay. Take a little trip around the police department. Crime Victims Board, We Care Walk-in Center, Town Hall Building. New York State medication drop-off. I heard a lot of citizens like the police here.
Fake pot is no joke. Oh, man. I like that. I'm all about the red, white, and blue. Crime victims can get help. Bicentennial. I'm gonna hold this right here. When he comes back out, I'll get him again.